Well, southern China is picking up the pieces after the worst storm the region has seen in 4 decades. Chinese state media says Typhoon Rammasun killed at least 33 people when it made landfall there late last week. Estimates put the damage at more than $1.5 billion. The Red Cross has brought in relief supplies to help those in heavily flooded areas. Meteorologist Pedram Javahari is tracking yet another typhoon which threatens the region.
As you see there on your screens, he joins us from the CNN Weather Center, and you can see it right behind you, Pedram. Look out.
Yeah, absolutely. Another monster storm system headed in this direction. And fortunately, this storm system, guys, is going to avoid really the area hardest hit south of Hong Kong and Guangdong province in the past week or so. But the feature is still packing winds over 150 kilometers per hour. Measures of the cloud field put it over 2,000 kilometers in length. And it's also sitting over very balmy sea surface temperatures, which really fuel the storm system. About 85, 86 degrees Fahrenheit, which puts it around 30 degrees Celsius. That's the water temperatures in this region. But the first area of impact right now, at least direct impact, going to be the central coast of Taiwan sometime around midnight on Tuesday, transitioning into Wednesday morning. Notice the winds gusting to 185. Again, this would be equivalent to almost a Category 2 there, just shy of a Category 2, but models do indicate it could peak closer to a Category 3 before landfall. So some strengthening is possible as it pushes into one of the most mountainous islands in the world there in the island nation of Taiwan, where we know the storm system will begin to weaken at least some. But a lot of communities across some of the hillsides in this region, really something to watch carefully, with extensive flash flooding a possibility in the forecast here. But even with all those mountains in its path, the storm system going to have enough juice, it looks like, behind it to push in towards China as it redevelops, possibly to yet another typhoon strength there before it weakens completely. And as far as rains are concerned, how about this? Some 26 centimeters in spots. You work your way inland, 75 centimeters. That's near the top of the charts when it comes to torrential rainfall. So we know significant flooding and landslides going to be a real possibility here in the next couple of days when the storm system moves in.